So tell me about what did you take from LOVELOUD or festivals?
That's actually a great question. I think that festivals are like music has the ability to bring people together from different backgrounds, whether it's political, religious, cultural, and to have people in one cause. And so I thought, you know, this could be a great way to bring two communities that are pretty separated right now, which is Orthodox religion and the LGBTQ community. They're at odds quite often because, well, it's pretty obvious, it's not a safe space for LGBTQ youth. So the goal is to get everybody together and at least agree on one thing, which is that we're losing lives of our youth to religious guilt. And that's undeniable. So we can all at least start there in the conversation, then maybe we can, you know, hopefully save some lives.
Yeah, thank you so much for meeting me. I'm just being gay and growing up in South Tennessee. It's been very easy. So I cried a bunch during the talk. I just had to So what do you plan to do in July that we
I think, first of all, we have so many amazing speakers. I wish I could tell you some of them that we have to announce it. But so there's going to be a lot of powerful community members that are going to get out and to our LGBTQ youth. I think the emphasis this year is all about putting that spotlight on our LGBTQ youth. And for me as a privileged white heterosexual male, I feel like LOVELOUD started with this spotlight because of the privilege I've been given, and what I'm trying to do is take that and shine it where it needs to be shined, which is on our LGBTQ youth. And so this year we're really going to try to maximize their stories and hopefully make it a safer community.
What's one thing you learned about Tyler Glenn? What was the
whole? Tyler is the greatest. I love that man. We serve the same mission, or mission, and we've just grown so close to this whole process. I think one of the things that I've learned about him is his resilience. You know, I think that anybody who grows up in a religious community, you have to have a certain resilience and courage to you that Tyler has. And
I think
he's
awesome.
Thank you
so much. Nice. Okay.
Yes, I think it's all about kind of living your truth and not fitting into a box of being a Jew. I'm not trying to conform to anybody, because people who try to tell you who they know the truth or who they, those are people you should stay away from, because that's danger. So behind it, so supportive, all of them have been incredibly supportive.
Would you ever move it to another location in Chicago?
You know what, I really do. I actually would love to continue to expand LOVELOUD. There are a lot of cities around the U.S. and the world that need this. They need this dialogue. And so we're starting in Utah, but I think we are determined. We have a team that is determined to take this out.
Can I just get a quick letter from you?
Yeah, of course.
This is for me and Lisa Hamilton for the mix.
It's a guy.
So, we'll just say your name and we'll say a non-stop music track.
Oh, yeah. This is Dan Reynolds from the Dragons.
Thank you so much. Can you just grab a quick photo?